this is nice, man.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This is going to be my review of the Canik TP9 Elite Combat. You've probably seen this going around the internet over the last year. And if you don't know what this is basically a Canik TP9 that has been absolutely pimped out. It's basically a Gucci gun that a lot of Glock guys like to do with their Glocks, is make them into Gucci Glocks. Well, you can do that with a Canik now, meaning that you can get basically a semi-custom gun, you know, that's got a bunch of salient parts on it. You can get a salient, customized Canik TP9 Elite Combat for well under $1,000, basically roughly, I'd say, $700. If you're lucky, you might even get it less than that. So let's take a look at this thing a little closer. So basically, it's a compact 9mm striker-fired polymer handgun, just like a Glock 19. And it's got the same kind of feel as a Glock 19. Very compact inside the waistband, outside the waistband. You can do that with this. It's a good EDC size compact gun. So let's start from top to bottom. So right off the bat, you're going to notice some things, right? That gold probably sticks out to you. That is a Salient Arms barrel. It even has Salient stamped into the top there. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it says S right there for Salient. It's got a little bit of relief there with the serial number, gold PVD coated. Let's go ahead and show you what that looks like. So there it is right there. It's got fluting and it is threaded 1/2 by 28, so you can run your favorite suppressors on there. Pretty good looking slide. It's got a flat spring with a steel guide rod. It's a fluted guide rod too. That's nice. No plastic guide rods here. And then you're gonna have to take that thread protector off to get the barrel out, but that's a good shot of what it looks like right there. You can kind of see it. It says SAI on the barrel. Very nice. All right, so to put this slide back on, you don't just put it on the front and slide it all the way back like on a Glock. You have to line it up. See these notches right here? You have to line those notches up and set it down like that, because basically you have to clear the ejector. There's no slot in the cover plate in the back, so you can't just slide it over like on a Glock. So one more time, you line the steel tabs like that, and then just rack it on. It's a little bit different than on Glocks. The slide itself is nitride coated. You have serrations in the front for those press checks, or just racking it, clearing malfunctions, whatnot. Slide serrations in the rear, nice and grippy. Slingshot over the top. You have a loaded chamber indicator right there. When a round's in there, it'll pop up. You have a removable optics plate here. So it comes with the standard plate with the rear sight. Just two bolts that are Loctited in there. Salient stamped rear sight. It's a combat style sight with the ledge there, so you can hit your belt or your boot to clear malfunctions one-handed, or maybe rack it off of an obstacle. You can do that. That's nice. Even has serrations in there too, so you can get good bite. And then you have serrations in the back, so there's no glare. And it looks like you have some set screws in there, so you can really like torque this thing down. It will not budge. That's pretty cool. A lot of sights don't do that. In the front, it's steel dovetailed, not plastic like on a Glock. And you have fiber optic inserts. So this is a red insert. It comes with a green as well, if you want to swap it out to green. You see the stamp there. It says TP9 Elite Combat right there on the slide. And then it just says Canik on that side. Overall aesthetics of this slide is pretty nice. It kind of reminds me of an HK with those slab cuts right there. It's really good looking. I like that. Of course, striker fired, when it's cocked, you'll see the red, meaning red, you're dead. It's cocked, ready to go. You press the trigger, it disappears. You cock it, it comes back. Moving down, you're going to notice it has very large ambidextrous slide stops or slide release, whatever you guys want to call it. But it is nice and enhanced, nice and big, so easy to lock back if you push up with your thumb, or obviously locks back with the mag in it. Or you can release with your trigger finger if you need to. One-handed on your trigger finger. Or if you're a lefty, obviously easy to hit with your left hand. Pretty cool, right? Nice. I like that. Standard takedown lever. Really nothing fancy there. Pretty standard. The trigger. You're going to notice that it has a flat aluminum trigger. That is a competition style trigger. That thing is very, very nice, guys. I took it to the range and shot it.
Oh, I like that flat trigger. It's a short, clean break with a short reset. That's nice. Oh, this is nice, man. That's a really good trigger. I'm not a trigger diva either, but that's nice. That is nice. I like it.
Absolutely love it. It is a huge upgrade for sure than the standard plastic triggers. So press, press, press. Here, I'll show you on this side here. Press. See that? Take up. Press. You hit the wall. You feel it. It stops. And then you press, press, press again. And nice clean break. The gun cycles. Now watch this. This is the cool part. Release it to reset. Wow. Very short. I don't know if you caught that, but that was a very short reset. And then press again to break. Nice crisp break. Here we go again. One more time. Reset. That is really short. And then trigger press. Nice clean break. Yeah, that is phenomenal, guys. You're getting your money's worth with this trigger. Trust me, guys. I'm vouching for them right here, right now. That's a really good trigger. You got some cutouts on the frame here for your thumb on both sides, which is nice. You have a little bit of an undercut on the trigger. Not much, but it is undercut a little bit, so you can get that high grip. There's no undercut on the bottom part of the trigger, and there's no cutouts on the front of the trigger. You can't see it because I have this X-Tech weapon light on here. It's just pretty much a standard square style trigger guard. It does have a beaver tail in the back so you don't get slide bite. See that? That's actually really nice. I love that. I can't stand that Glocks have an afterthought clamp-on piece. I don't like that. I wish they would make it from the factory with a beaver tail just like this. This is phenomenal. The grip itself has some stippling from the factory on both sides, obviously. Feels good, not too aggressive. In the front, you got some more boxy stippling or checkering on the front. And then the back strap has some checkering as well. This is the standard back strap. It has another one you can put on here if you want it to be a little bit bigger. The magazine release is enhanced. You can actually change this out to small, medium, or large. So that's kind of nice. And it even has the letter on there too. I don't know if you guys can see that on camera. It says M, but you can go with S or you can go with L. So that's nice if you want to be able to hit that mag release easily. That's nice. Moving down, you have an aluminum flared magwell from Salient. It's even stamped with an S from Salient. It screws in with a hex head bolt to make those mag changes a little bit easier. Funnels it in there. And it just looks cool too. You know, this is a Gucci gun. And I like the fact that it's aluminum and not plastic. The magazine is by Metgar. It's a steel magazine made in Italy with a +3 metal base pad. So basically you got 15, 16, 17, 18 rounds in this magazine, plus one in the chamber. That's 19 rounds, guys, in a compact handgun. Pretty nice. On the dust cover here, you have a 1913 style Picatinny rail that you can't see because I have this X-Tech weapon light on there, which I'll do a full video on, but this thing's pretty badass, guys. I saw these guys at SHOT Show 2020, and they came out with this new weapon light. It's so cool. As a matter of fact, it fits on here perfectly. I like how it's flush. It's a green laser and a white light. This thing has something kind of cool. If you hold it down for 3 seconds, now you can turn it on just by breaking the plane. There's a sensor right here. So if I put my finger right here, let's just say I put my thumb up like that, I can turn the light on without even putting my finger on a button. It's just breaking the plane. So on this side, you can see it better here too. So here, trigger finger breaks the plane, but it's not inside the trigger well and it's not touching the trigger. See that? It's not touching the trigger and it's not inside the trigger guard. So as the mindset behind this is laying on your nightstand at night, you hear a bump in the night, you grab this and the light is already there for you. You don't have to hit a button, it's ready to go. And if you need to take a shot, boom. And for the guys that don't believe in using your trigger finger, which I agree with, same thing. Bump in the night, you pick it up, support hand. Your thumb goes right over that sensor, just like you normally would. And it comes on. I'll do a full video on that light later. But it does go really good with this compact Canik TP9 Elite Combat. All right, so let's take a look at the box. What's inside here? So the box is big because this is a special edition. So you're gonna get a lot of goodies in here. And what you get essentially is a bunch of paperwork. Some of you guys are nerds and read this stuff. In the lid, you get a paddle holster. So you can put the holster right on here, right out of the box. You don't have to buy one. You can go with this. You have a bore brush. You have another cleaner, like a bore tool. And there's your suppressor wrench to take the thread protector off. Over here on this side, you have that Kydex level 2 holster. I guess this is a level 2 holster. It's got a lock on there. So you could use this. Some guys like them, some guys don't. But at least you have one from the right from the factory. You got a lock. Here is your spare back strap for bigger back straps. Here is your RMR plate if you want to run an optic on the gun. You have magazine loader, a second magazine, 15 rounds, but this one does not have a base pad. And then, of course, your accessory box that comes with all kinds of little goodies in here. Let's see here. I'll show you guys. Small, medium, and large magazine buttons, extra screws, red and green fiber optics, and here's something kind of cool. That's a charging handle that mounts right there on that RMR plate. So if you're a competition guy and you want to use that for competition, you can actually charge the gun with a charging handle. All right, guys, so there you have it. That is my review of the Canik TP9 Elite Combat. Pretty phenomenal, compact, striker-fired 9mm for only $699. Probably even cheaper now if you're lucky. But again, $699 for a salient semi-custom gun. That's, you get a lot, guys. Gold PVD barrel, threaded barrel, optics ready, combat sights, ambidextrous controls, upgraded trigger, flat aluminum, flared magwell, extended base plate. I mean, that's a lot, guys. That is a lot for $699. All right, guys, so hit that like button to support my channel. I appreciate it. It helps me out a lot. Ring that bell so you can be notified when new videos are uploaded. And leave a comment below. Let me know what you think about the Canik TP9 Elite Combat Salient Edition. Thanks a lot, guys. Take care.